Well, folks, here it is, finally. The grand reveal of Tripod 2.0. And I can hear a few people in the background going, fucking finally. Yes, I know, it kind of sucks that I upload a teaser video last year, 9 or 8 months ago, and then just go completely silent, leaving everybody in the dark thinking that they'll never get to see it, because apparently I was just dead. And not to say that I wasn't dead, but I was just kind of lacking in motivation and inspiration at the time. But, you know, I guess, as some would say, sooner than later, or later than sooner, or just bottom line, at least now, it's finally here. And I know for a few of you, you'd be kind of wondering, you know, why we showing this off first, rather than, you know, going back to the old cruise ship and Snowpiercer projects. Well, while I am very much understanding that those projects are kind of what bring my channel into the spotlight, it definitely is a bit of a curveball with this, because even though years and years back, like way back on, I think it was PS3 times, whenever I put together my very first model of the tripod way back when, that thing is minuscule compared to this, you know, 2.0 model, but nonetheless, you know, to say that even that older model, it got quite a bit of interest and a lot of views and a lot of comments, and it kicked off so hard that a few of you even convinced me to try to put together a tutorial on it. And while that tutorial was a bit flubbernucked in and of itself because I was young, dumb, and couldn't remember numbers to save my life, I put it together nonetheless, and as far as I understand, some people made it work, but I guess for others there was a part that I was missing. I think it had something to do with the third leg, but seeing as how I don't have my PS3 anymore, I couldn't access that world back even if I wanted to, so it just kind of became an X-file, if you would. So, considering that the old model got so much attention back when, and as I've gotten older and wiser, I've also developed quite a much more greater interest in the world, the world's universe myself, it, of course, was kind of a no-brainer that perhaps that I should probably attempt to make a much more detailed, a much more upscaled, and more accurate model, at least to my capabilities, and eventually show it off to the world, and lo and behold, here it is. So, rather than just kind of flying around it, I guess let's get a little bit more up close and personal with this. And to do that, I'm going to need to engage some night vision so you can get a better look at some of the finer details here. And so, let's actually start down here at the bottom. Just so you all can get a general idea of just how much bigger this thing is and just how tall and menacing these machines could really be. So, where do I start here? So, of course, putting this project together, of course, this is probably the next little evolutionary curve in my Minecraft capabilities because, of course, building the front of ships and such is a very organic project in and of itself, but this has definitely got to be the most sophisticated and complex Minecraft build I've ever put together, simply because of the fact of the legs. The legs of the tripod are always probably the hardest thing to put together for any Minecrafter who's trying to make their own model of these things. And even for my little project here, of course, as I was putting it together and trying to get it as organic and slender as I possibly could, in comparison to some photos and illustrations and just screenshots of the movie and such, it definitely does kind of show that my model here, the legs are probably a little bit more on the beefy side. They don't really look as skinny as some folks would probably desirably would like them to look, but considering that we're working with blocks and I was only just kind of eyeballing pictures on Google Images and just kind of sculpting it to look how it should and just how much I've watched the movie and how much I could just remember of how the head looked, and you know, I mean, it was definitely quite, you know, quite the project, and definitely took quite a long while, because even after the initial teaser video, it kind of sat for a little bit, and then whenever I was cooking up the idea of kicking my YouTube channel back off again, I started to get to work on this, because I was always kind of intending on this being the first thing I came back to. So, aside from the legs, we got the toes, going back to the toes here, and I actually did pay attention to the fact that rather than it just being a big, fat, circular ring at the bottom of each toe, I did notice in the movie, and even in screenshots and such, that it does actually have these, I don't know what the hell you'd call them, it's not like really toes, but these additional flanges that kind of extend out just before the tripod, you know, touches the ground. So I think it had like 3 to 4 of these little external, not external, but extendable pieces, but Being that this is Minecraft and trying to keep things at least symmetrical to a degree, I just went with four on each toe, and they're definitely pretty beefy, probably a bit too thick, but then again, like I say, I'm working with blocks here, so there's only so much you can do. And that's pretty much the shindig for each feet. We got the little ankle shields that they seem to have up on the front of each leg. It wasn't quite sure how those go together, but in some of the photos that I've seen, they had like this weird ribbing texture on the backside, so each of the leg has that. And of course, the front two legs are mirrored to one another. The middle leg is a bit different. And I know you're probably kind of looking at the contouring of the legs here and how the third, yeah, the center leg, the I don't know, the not the ribbing, but the curvature of the hind leg seems to be a little bit lower than that of the four legs, but in the side, side shots and diagrams that I could find of the tripod, that's how they had it illustrated, so that's how I went with it. And kind of going up here to, I guess, what you would consider the forearms, it's like they definitely had a bit of a different texture to them, and of course, another kind of like metallic overlapping ribbing effect, and I don't know, just to get the texture or at least the overall depth of it to look accurate, I just kind of did stairs and a darker, or a lighter shade of gray and all that fun things in between. And the underbelly of it, I still haven't quite gotten it sealed off because I just haven't been able to get a lot of good photos of what this particular section of it looks like. I could probably just continue the whole V shape and just seal it off, and just in a conventional shape, but I don't know, I just haven't gotten to that part yet. And then, of course, you can kind of see the three connecting joints as to where I put out the general layout as how far apart I thought the legs needed to be. But even with that being said, I didn't start with the legs, I actually started with the head. I just kind of stuck it way up high in the sky, and then built the legs down until I got about the dimensions I wanted, and then just structure blocked the whole thing down to ground level, and now it sits as it does now. So, moving up to the head, as you can see, I haven't included the heat rays yet, because, I don't know, I just haven't gotten around to it. But one of the things that I did try to include on this new model that was missing from the old model was I was trying to include like these weird like flipper arms that they have up, on the fore end of their, I don't know, torso, hips, midsection, whatever the hell you want to call this part of the tripod. Because I mean, you see some of the, I think all the tripods in the movie had these anyways. I mean, definitely in the ferry scene, you can see that they were using these things to push and capsize the ferry, so they do kind of function as being like little miniature arms, though they're not extendable in any way, so I guess they're just more or less about like ramming or shoving things that are like really tall or just up close to the torso if they crouch, because generally speaking, they would have like a gazillion tentacles coming out from the undercarriage, which I haven't gotten to those yet, because safe to say, putting these legs together for as organic and sculpted as they are, it definitely took a lot out of my brain putting that together. And so then, moving up from the midsection, the hips or torso, whatever the hell you want to call it, you got the neck piece. Not really anything great. I do know that there's supposed to be like a ribbing texture of like overlapping metal parts that would be here, but seeing as how without night vision you can't really see much of this section anyways, I just didn't really pull the trigger on putting that little bit of detail there. And so then, moving up to the actual head itself, well, you got the distinctive three spotlights, the bigger one up front, and it was kind of a bit of a challenge here around. I guess this would be what you would consider the cockpit section, at least if it had an interior. Which I will say that mine does not have an interior, but there is quite the volume of space here to put an interior together here. I mean, hell, it's like if I wanted to, you could stand in here, knock this out, and there you go. You can see where you're going, except not really. So we'll put that back. And so let's go back up front here. So yeah, about the spotlight here, I was very much aware of like how behind the main spotlight they had like these additional rings of smaller little lights just kind of scattered all down the I guess the neck, as you would, of the cockpit. So definitely trying to put that together with blocks and slabs and just trying to get it to look the part, at least from head on. I mean, it definitely suits the look, but I mean, from different angles it looks a bit janky. And then of course, the auxiliary spotlights, nothing really special about that. And aside from underneath the hood, nothing being there, that's pretty much about it for at least the face of the tripod. So moving up to the actual hood, I guess as they call it. Yeah, got the little weird triangular. I don't know. Probably not bulges. I don't even know what the purpose of those for, if it's just to make it look more alien, or maybe it's just to add more internal volume to spaces where the secondary spotlights are, depending on what the interior layout of the tripod's heads would be like, because no one really seems to know. But then you have like this weird, this weird little hump on top that I guess some people would say it's like the skylight or something. There's quite a number of different things on the tripod that just doesn't really have much of an explanation for it. And considering the lack of detail that there was on some of the models I found of the tripod, there were a couple of illustrations on Google Images that had like this weird roof rack, I guess is one would call it. Kind of, I don't know if it's supposed to make it look a little bit more industrialistic or something, but yeah, some of them had like these like ribbed roof racks on top and like these angular spike looking dorsal antennas. Whether they served a purpose, if they actually picked up radio waves or anything of the sort, it's anybody's guess, but they were there on a number of the, on a number of the models, and some models didn't. So just to kind of fill the barren wasteland that was the top of this model, I went ahead and put them in there. And then kind of skirting along the edge here, now this was definitely quite an interesting result here, because seeing how long the edges of the hood, they have like this fluorescent, like a purple bluish, purple bluish panels all along the edge of the head that glow and flicker. You can kind of see the coloring and the lighting, waving all along, and just basically giving a lot more of an alien look, and I guess more texture and just ambient afterglow, as some would say. But or actually, now that I think about it, a few of you are probably wondering, it's like what block this is, and I probably should throw this out there, but probably should, should have said it at the beginning of the video. But I am using a texture pack, so this might kind of have a little bit of a hindrance on if I ever have the idea of trying to put this together as a tutorial of some sort, because I do very much have the idea of making a tutorial for this, for those of you who are in the comments already asking or wondering. It's like, yes, I have noticed on the teaser, and even on the older tripod model, that there's bound to be the number of people wanting a tutorial for this. Man, I cannot English right now. It's like, it's probably a bit early to be doing a YouTube video, but nonetheless, here I am doing it. But yeah, tutorial. I do have the intention on making it happen. I'm just gonna have to forewarn you that it's going to be a doozy. This is gonna be one hell of a complex tutorial, so it's probably gonna take some time for me to figure out how I'm gonna try to segment it, or try to see how uniform I can make it, or just how smooth, or yeah, smooth on me and smooth for you to get it done, because there's gonna be a lot of numbers and a lot of layers and a lot of awkward shapes and spaces to put together here. But nonetheless, continuing the little overlook here. So yeah, the fluorescent panels along the edge here, and then of course we got like the exhaust outlets of like the red weed or the terraforming fluid or human's blood mist, whatever the hell you want to call it. Now, these, now that I look at it, might be a bit excessive or a bit large in dimension, but at least in the initial scene where Ray grenades the inside of one and it's falling around, yeah, it's stumbling, I did notice that it had one large outlet and then also a smaller one behind it, so I incorporated that one on the back. And then, I guess also doubling back down to the neck here, I always kind of noticed that on some of the models and, fucking cave noise for a heart attack, Jesus, that snuck up on me. Whew, that kind of made me skip a beat, though. Anyway, actually, can I, yeah, reinvest in night vision here, boy, that brightened everything up. So yeah, behind the neck, there was always seemed to be on a number of the models this like auxiliary neck piece or this hose or something that was connected to the back of the head behind the main neck. So I threw that in there, and then, excuse me, as far as like the actual rear of the torso or the midsection is concerned, couldn't really find many angles or photos of this area, so I'm still having to kind of wing it on this part. And then, last but not least, we move over here to the baskets. Now, these probably may not be the best iterations of baskets that one could put together, but safe to say it's like it's very much like a cage, and you can't exactly fall through. I mean, you could fall through it initially with the fencing like that, so that's kind of why I had to put the trap doors underneath it to kind of keep you from slipping out of it. And you can kind of see I even have like the I don't even know what the hell you'd call those, just the abduction tubes or entrances or something like that. Let's actually, yeah, you know what? We can get inside the cages this way. Yeah, so not really much of anything happening up in here. So you go down in here, and voila. You are abducted, you are captured, and you are doomed to die. Unless you have a belt full of grenades. But yeah, so got the cages, got the harvester. I guess you would call this like the harvest inlet or something like that, because anyone and everyone knows that once you get sucked into this, it's probably to the blender with you, and you basically become nutrient food for the aliens, and then also terraforming byproduct that they disperse everywhere. So, the long and short of it, that's pretty much all I've got on the Tripod 2.0 model. And actually, for the few of you eyeballing that in the background here, just before I was getting this video put together, I was well, not fabricating, but experimenting with the gimmick of trying to make it look like the head was tilting down and kind of looking at somebody closer to the ground. Because, yes, I actually was entertaining the idea of trying to make a variant of the tripod model that was actually in a crouching position. But seeing as how much longer it would take for me to put that together and also have this on standby and try to do a showcase of both at the same time would definitely prolong the release date of whenever I would get this to, be a thing. And also trying to recreate the tripod legs in a different organic curvature altogether was not really motivating me at the time because I was already suffering from brain rot after all this was said and done. But yeah, the grand, not grand, but yeah, so the whole idea here is to have the head look like it was tilted downward and looking at somebody at ground level. So it was just kind of more or less chopping it into individual sections and just kind of adding or basically conforming it with structure blocks to like a much steeper and even rake. And also I was having to do something with the front end, yeah, the front fascia to kind of also tuck the vertical space. You know, the vertical piece is inward to a degree, because at this angle it just kind of looks like the head, just taller. It's not really got a whole proper downward look to it. So I still have that much of it to mess with, and then also figure out how I'm going to get the legs and stuff put together here. And I don't know if I'd be willing to make that part into a tutorial after it's all said and done, but if I am, or if I'm going to, I'm probably going to wait until after I get this one done before I do a tutorial on either one of them, because, like I say, it's going to be quite a long time before a tutorial even comes into fruition for these things, just because of how complex and just how much shit there's going to be to work with here. But I am very much understanding as to why a lot of you would very much like a tutorial on this, because I know some of you have probably attempted to make a model and just can't quite get it to look right, or maybe you just aren't comfortable or confident in yourself to make something this complex. And not that to be an insult or anything, don't take that the wrong way. I mean, we all have our capabilities and the things that we can and can't do. I mean, hell, it's like I can build cruise ships and ocean liners, back to back, day to day, as many times as I'd like, any way I'd like, but I cannot build a castle or anything medieval to save my life. So yeah, everyone's got their things on Minecraft. And I know a few of you would be like, well, wouldn't you want this to be kind of like unique to you? It's like, well, I mean, there is like a bit of a popular effect on that. It's like, anymore, I'm not really too stingy about people having, having the same things I do. Because if anything, it's just more or less just a little a loving addition to the fan base. Because I know for a fact that that the few of you, or probably the abundance of you, I would imagine there's going to be a lot of you that would very much like a tutorial on this. You know, if you could add this to your worlds and do whatever the hell you'd want with it, I would imagine you all would par. Yeah, prob. Prob. Yeah, like I say, I can't English right now. But yeah, you could probably put together some pretty interesting maps, or horror maps, or story maps, and hell, maybe for the few of you that might try to fabricate this on PC, you could probably make like a mod for this thing to actually make it move or make it into an NPC. That would actually be dope as fuck. Yeah, now I'd actually be just completely willing to do a tutorial just for that. Like, if somebody could mod this and make it into like a ginormous sized like NPC of some sort, like an entity, that'd be sweet. God, yeah, then you could pretty much just make World of Worlds in Minecraft. All right, little post-production insert here, just before I got it all. Yeah, before I got that video all put together, I had actually completely spaced on the idea that I hadn't shown you what this thing looks like at nighttime, because it definitely has some illumination to it and some pretty interesting glowing effects. At least as far as this texture pack is concerned, it's like, I mean, down at the feet, just a couple of little spotlights ain't nothing spectacular. Of course, all the main spotlights up front glow. There's a couple of more auxiliary lights kind of tucked away down the torso and such. And probably the more interesting factor is that with this texture pack, I think it's like one of the frog lamps or whatever the hell they call them. But this texture anyway has like a blue, yellow, and purple variant of this block, and it looks like this with this texture pack, and seeing how this is purple, and it was more befitting to that of the tripod design, and just kind of putting a glass, you know, tinted glass overcoat on it just to darken it and make it more color match the tripod, definitely gives it that interesting texture as far as like the glowy bits are concerned. And even down below, there's even an example of that block in blue around the little, red weed outlet, because I guess it actually had like a little line of blue lights surrounding it. They were very small and individual, but they were there if you knew where to look. And also kind of up here on the back of the head alongside the harvester inlets and the cages, you know, along the center spine, they had all those little lines of ambient lights down the middle. So all those are incorporated, and yeah. So this is what the tripod would look like at nighttime after it was all said and done. And maybe, just for the hell of it, let's go back down to ground level and take a peek at this thing from below. And, yep, that would be what you'd be looking at if you were underneath it as it was walking over you at nighttime. You can see the glowy bits, the purple trim, and all that good stuff. Not really any kind of ambient light down here near the toes, aside from the one little ankle shield light. Not that they really serve much for actual light projection anyways. So yeah, just kind of figured I'd throw this in here real quick before I capped off the original video. Put it in real quick, so now you know. Just in case someone might have been ready to gripe, like, but we didn't get to see it at night. Like, what does it look like at night? Well, here it is. Now you know. It's like, that was almost a my bad on my part. So, now I'm just going to let it jump to the outro. In Minecraft. But anyway, rather than monologuing too much more and taking up more of your time, I mean, even though it's a Friday night, we all got the weekend to look after. Still, I'm talking too much as is, so I guess as my new outtake would go, or not an outtake, but outro would have it, as I'm going to say nowadays, it's like, you take care of yourselves out there, and, you know, have a good morning, good evening, or a good night, whichever the case may be, and hey, if ever you need somebody to put a smile on your face, or just need someone to help make your day just a little bit better, well, you now know where to find us. You missed, white boy! You white boy, you can't sweep with shit!
You're a white woman, what's your point?
Exactly! This motherfucker can't swing for shit. Anyway. There, try that.